we will go to sites.google.com. We will visit sites.google.com, right? And once the website opens, we will be asked to sign in. So we will select our email account and we will enter the password. Now once we have signed in, this is the home page. This is the Google Sites dashboard that will open up, right? Okay, so now we have to understand what Google Sites actually is. So Google Sites is a web publishing tool which is provided to us by Google itself, right? The company Google, fine. And using Google Sites, we can create our own free website and we can publish it on the internet or on the world wide web, fine, using the number of tools that Google is providing us, right? Okay, so on this dashboard there are multiple things that we can see, right? The right hand top side corner shows your Google account, the one you are currently logged in with, fine. And at the bottom in the right hand corner you will find there is a plus icon, right? So if you hover over that plus icon, it changes to a pencil icon or a pen icon and it says create new site. So in order to start working on our new site, we will simply click on this and it will keep loading and it will bring us to the dashboard of our new site, right? So there is a pop-up option, unsure where to begin, but we are sure we don't need that, right? So this is the landing page for our untitled site. See, this has no name right now. It is being called a untitled site. Fine. So at the center of this page, we can see an image where it is written your page title, enter site name, add logo. And beyond this, there are other multiple options that we can see on the, right hand side of the page. So this central part of the page is the actual display or the actual page contents that are being shown here, right? In the central part we can see the actual page contents, fine. And the right hand part, the right hand side dashboard, where there are three options: insert, pages and themes, right? In this right hand side part we have the different tools that are available to us for creating or developing our page, fine. So as we can see, this top portion of the page is called a header. It's called a header. Just like in any Word document, we have a header and a footer, right? So this portion of the page is being called the header. Now if we want, there's a dustbin here and we can simply click on it and delete the header, but we won't do that right now. What we will do is we will quickly go through the options which are available for the header, right? So what we can do is we can change the image. Right now we won't do that, the image will remain, but let's see the options. We can have an option of uploading another image, or we can select an image from among the contents of our Google Drive, etc. Also we could change the type of the header. Right now the header is set as a banner, right? It was set as a banner. If we want, we could have only the title as a header. We could have a larger banner as the header, or we could have it as a cover, right? It would take a lot of space, fine. Let's go back to the banner option and keep it the way it was, right? Now the page title, the header is showing a content, a written content as your page title. Now first we'll select it. We will select the page title contents and we will delete it, right? So the cursor will keep blinking and we are supposed to type in some contents as the contents of the header, right? Now the whole project of going through Google Sites for us is about creating a curriculum vitae, right? A curriculum vitae is nothing but a detailed document of your academic, your research or your accomplishments, right? All your accomplishments are be listed there. They can be listed in a curriculum vitae. So whenever you're sitting for a campus interview, you're supposed to provide your curriculum vitae. Often we call it a resume too, right? So we are trying to create an online curriculum vitae. We'll have our own Google site, and on that Google site we will be displaying all our details, our academic details, our accomplishments, our skills, all of it on a website, right? So we will work through that in this project. So right now, in the header part, we will write the text curriculum vitae. Right? So I have written down the text and it is coming out in two lines, right? And I don't like that. So what can I do? I can simply pull these arrows. I can pull these arrows and it comes back to a single line. The box has been, increased in length. Fine. But this is not in the center. And if you hover over the borders of this box, you will find that there is no option of moving it anywhere, right? Yeah, there's an option of moving it when we come to this part. And we can simply drag it and we can see that we have brought it to the middle, right? So right now the header says curriculum vitae, and the header of any website should always explain what that site is about, right? So in our case, this header is explaining that this is our curriculum vitae. That is all well and good. Now once we have begun with this, once we have begun editing our site, the next thing we want to do out of excitement is we want to view how this site looks. We will come to that a few moments later, right? So the next thing that we will learn for today's lecture is we will go through this part. There is something called layouts, right? There is something called layouts. Now whatever content we will add in our page, we are supposed to add content to our page, right? Because the only content our page has by default is a header and nothing else. So we can add contents of different types, right? We can add Google Forms, we can add sheets, documents, a map, we can add calendar, we can add YouTube videos, we can add buttons. We'll go through most of these things, right, time to time. Today we'll start with the most basic layout, which is the first one, right, this one. We will simply click on it and drag it below the header. As you will find, this plus icon appears, right? There's a plus icon that appears, and beside that plus icon, we have an option called click to edit text, right? Click to edit text. First, this plus icon, we'll come to this. This plus icon is supposed to help us add an image, right? So what this layout represents is, on the left side, there will be an image, and on the right hand side, beside that image, we will add some text, fine? So we will be using this, tool of the layout, for beginning with our curriculum vitae. So we'll click on the plus icon and we will click on upload, right? Once we click on upload, it will bring us to our local machine's desktop. We will simply click on the profile picture or whatever picture you want to set as our profile, right? Which will be displayed on the website, fine? So that picture has been uploaded. We can see that the picture has been uploaded, but the picture has been cropped, right? The whole picture is not being shown. So above the picture, we'll find a number of options. There is something called crop, uncrop, insert link, delete, etc. Right? So first, in order to bring out the whole picture, we'll click on uncrop. Once we click on uncrop, we'll find that the whole picture is now being displayed, but the picture is a bit too large, right? The picture is a bit too large for my liking, so I can simply go to this corner edge by clicking, by hovering over the dot, it turns into an arrow. I can simply click and I can drag. Once I start dragging, I can very easily shorten the whole picture box, right? So once I am done shortening the picture box up to my satisfaction, that is the way I have already inserted my picture into my website, in my curriculum vitae site, right? Okay, the next thing to do, we can add some text here, right? We can add some text here. So, as a part of a curriculum vitae, the text we are supposed to add here is our name, our own name. So, let's say my name is Anonymous. My first name is Anonymous, my second name is Person, right? This is my name. Now when I click outside, I can see that below the header, there is my pic and there is my name called Anonymous Person. So this place is supposed to hold your name, right? Okay. So, and the next thing we can do is, below this Anonymous Person text, we have another field where it is written, click to edit text, right? If we click on that, we can put in other details, like let's say our email ID. Email ID, right? So we will simply type in email ID equal to anonymous.p@gmail.com. Fine. We can. Once we finish typing, we can simply click outside, and this is what will be displayed. Fine. So we have put in some contents to our website. We will be customizing our Google site day after day, right? And in the end, we will have a fine looking curriculum vitae. We will work through all the options that we have here in the Google Sites dashboard also, right? So the next thing that we would like to do out of excitement again is that we would like to publish our website, right? We would love to publish our website and see how it looks. So let's head on and let's click on publish. So now we'll click on publish, right? When we click on it, a window will open, a pop-up window where it says that we are supposed to enter the web address. We'll find that the cursor is blinking here, right? Before entering the web address, let's look at something written below this box, right? It is written HTTPS, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure, right? This we have already gone through, followed by the URL, which is sites.google.com/view/, right? So whatever web address we put in here, whatever text I write in here, that text will be put after sites.google.com/view/, and that will be our web page. That is the address at which our web page will be displayed, right? Fine. So in order to put in the web address, we will follow a convention, right? We will type in the first name. We will type in our first name. In my case, my first name is Anonymous, right? Anonymous, followed by the second alphabet of my last name. My last name is Person. So the first alphabet of my last name is P, right? So my web address will be Anonymous P, fine. And at the extreme right hand corner of this box, we'll find a tick icon, which means that this web address is available, right? Many a times it happens that for certain common names or common words, the web address is not that unique, it is not available, right? But for us, we are lucky, it is available right now, right? Moving ahead, there is a scope of adding a custom URL. We won't go to that right now because we don't have any paid URLs, right? Who can view my site? Anyone on the web, that is fine. And for search settings, request public search engines not to display my site? No, we won't do that. We are done with this part, so we'll simply click on publish, right? Once you click on publish, it will show publishing, and a pop-up will come up at the bottom. Your site has been published successfully, and there will be a view option, but we won't click on it right now, right? The option will vanish on itself. Does that mean that I can never view my site again? I can always view my site. There will be a drop-down arrow beside the publish option. If we hover on it, it will show the same publish options. Clicking on that arrow, we will find four options, and the third option says view published site, right? We will click on that. A new tab will open and our site will be loaded, right? And this, mind it, is live on the web, right? This site is live on the internet, right? And our site address is, as we had seen, sites.google.com/view/anonymousp, which we had typed in. But Google site has now added a new subpart, which is /home to our site. We don't want this thing, right? What we had wanted was sites.google.com/view/anonymousp. But right now, Google Sites have added another part called /home. In the next lecture, we'll see how to remove this part, fine, and how to customize the site more. Right now, all the contents that we have put in the site, the header, our picture, my name, and my email address, all of the things are being displayed in proper shape, right? So if I reload this site, I can always view the same content again and again. So this thing is live on the internet. So we'll learn more about working through Google Sites in the next lecture. Thank you.